NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Osweiler's Texans going up against Bortles' Jaguars. With that, let's head up the road to Jacksonville, Florida. Standing by are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, it's a good matchup in the AFC South between the Houston Texans and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And you know, Charles, as Larry pointed out in the open, got a couple of great quarterbacks set to square off here this afternoon. That ball's probably going to be flying all over the place, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt. And the game has never been more quarterback-centric than it is now. And both of these teams have top-flight signal callers.
Here's the kicker, Nick Novak, to get us started. And off we go from Jacksonville. Here's Corey Grant now to return. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Jacksonville Jaguars coming out on offense led by Blake Bortles. Looking back at that Thursday night game in Week 8, you know, the final numbers in that loss to Tennessee, they don't look all that bad. 337 yards, three touchdowns, but a lot of that came in quote-unquote garbage time.
Reminds me a little bit of 2015 season, because he had terrific numbers when you added them up at the end of the year. But a few of those analytics people did say a good number of those came in garbage time in 2015. They want those same numbers when the game's on the line.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now the former Jet running back. This is Chris Ivory. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line. Hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
They stay on the ground. Ivory again. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. The Jags really haven't been able to get much going on the ground, Charlie. And Ivory, his carry's a bit hamstrung by the fact that they've gotten down early, had to throw the ball a lot.
Hasn't helped him one bit. In addition, remember earlier this year, he was sick, had to miss a game. And they've lost some key pieces in the offensive line, including Luke Jokel, who was supposed to start at guard for them this year. It's been a tough road trying to run the football for Jacksonville.
Yeah, between Ivory and T.J. Yeldon, two combined for just 26 yards on 7 carries last Thursday night in Week 8. So we've reached the end of a fairly even first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score. More from Jacksonville after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside the former defensive back Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Jaguar football as we begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with a first down. Down. Lee's got it over the middle. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask. 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
And now a first down following that long gain. Throwing on first down is Bortles. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Bortles to throw on second down. It's caught right side. It turns. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. So the offense has it first and 10. Right,
green 90.
On first and 10, here's Bortles. Completes it to Lee. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Call it a gain of 3. And that'll make it second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Seven yards to go on second down. Bortles again to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were in bounds, and they were.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there? Did you see how his toes got down? Tip tap, got him down. But what did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no steak.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you plays like that, you at least expect a first down. They're just 1 yard.
Throwing his Bortles on third down. And quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. And Myers able to knock it through, and the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. So they get the field goal here at the end of the second quarter and take the lead into the lockers.
And isn't that what every team wants to do right at the end of the half? Put points on the board and go into the locker room feeling a lot better about themselves.
Now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So we hit the halftime break here in Jacksonville with the Jags on top as we send you downstate to Orlando to check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Jaguars right now have a time of possession advantage, but it has not led them to taking control of this game. The Texans look like they'll be in this game for 4 quarters. All right, here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Jaguars later on the drive, Bortles with the completion over the middle, and it's going to end up going for a gain of 7. Middle of the field, the pass will be caught, and it's going to end up going for a gain of 7. Sticking with the same drive, it's Bortles with the completion over the middle, and that connection will lead to a gain of 9 yards. That'll do it for us here at EA Sports Studios. Let's get back out to Brandon and Charles for the call of the second half. Brandon.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Setback. They'll give it to him here, and he'll get this one up to the 26. A gain of 3, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Osweiler on second down. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Bartney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cruel. Of fun. It's almost like you say, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Jacksonville. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Screen from Miller, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks, and the offense moving quickly to the line. Back to throw, finding time toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Fresh set of downs here. He's back to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Someone to throw to. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. This is Alfred Blue. Oh, what a move. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Let's go! Green, 39!
Back to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. They may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
Try to punch it in with Miller. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going.
Let's do it quick.
on is Nick Novak. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Is Nick Novak now for the Texans field goal. This to potentially send us to overtime. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Here comes Grant on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. This is Ivory. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. Well, four quarters wasn't enough, my friend, and it turns out overtime is not enough. There's no PKs in American football, and this one is over, dead even.
Can you imagine the teams in their locker room now going back over this game, analyzing every play, each guy thinking, if I had done this on this play or that on the... Who knows what could have happened? Because let's face it, a tie can be exciting to go through to get into overtime, but it's not satisfying for either one.
Between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
Here on first down. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. A first down carry now for Miller. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
That was a good, strong run there. And while it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Second down, here's Miller. And some room to roam now. And he's brought down.
Look at the block in the back. Offense.
To go here on second down.
All right, here we go. Green.
Out of the gun, it's Osweiler. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final stoppage here in overtime, and we'll be back. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now a handoff to Miller, and he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down. Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and I missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you, so it doesn't matter. But thanks for sharing a booth, and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from Jacksonville.